The album came about because 2 years ago, you probably know, Deacon Blue reformed for a charity, which started off a whole kind of chain of events. We ended up from that one gig going on to do a tour and all really enjoying it. And at the end of that tour, thinking, well, what do we do now? You know, we're all doing other things and we're all quite happy doing other things, but we had enjoyed it and it would be nice to have done more. But I think we all felt quite strongly that we could only go out and do a tour again if we had new material to play to people. And we didn't have a record deal at that point, so there was no way of making that happen. But Ricky was actually offered a record deal last year by Papillon Records, and they said to him, is there any chance of you doing a Deacon Blue album at the same time? So it was actually just too good an opportunity really to miss, and we all agreed that we wanted to do it. So that's really how it came about, and here we are. I think it's just a natural kind of progression from where we were. I don't think it's taken any alternative route, maybe that whatever you say nothing to, a more kind of left field route for us. This one feels more vintage Deacon Blue, classic Deacon Blue, ordinary Deacon Blue.
Yeah. I mean, I think people always have enormous expectations of new albums, and every time we brought out an album, I was thinking about this the other day, that when we brought out a second album, which was the most commercially successful, we were told in the press, apparently, that none of our fans liked it. You know, they went on to kind of sell huge ones, because everyone has kind of this thing, oh, you make this great album. And looking back on it, I think there are good songs on Rain Town, there are good songs on all the records, but I actually think that this, you know, song for song is as good as anything we've done.
You value what you earn. shirt out, job hurts, but don't pay. All these calls and making been driving you insane. Don't you see? Don't you understand? Waiting for my phone to ring to make me all I am. Sure in the suburbs, waiting for somewhere to go. I'm down here working on some dumb show.
Them have grown up with us, you know, especially people that you meet that talk about Rain Town, you know, who that was their student, the music to their student life, you know, or whatever, when they were getting married, this was played at their wedding and stuff. And it is actually brilliant to see these people 12 years down the line.
I think that's also why it's good for them that we actually do something or continue to write, because it's part of their story. So it's not just, you know, we weren't just a pop group, we weren't just about putting singles in the charts and putting on nice clothes and doing dance routines. I mean, I think that's all
great. We tried that, we're going to do it anyway.
I think that's all. Not to put any of that stuff down, I think that's fine, but that just wasn't what we were about. We were just about trying to. The importance of song was the only thing that I was ever interested in. I was only ever interested in being a songwriter and getting songs out to people and connecting with people through songs. So if people have, in some ways, got into the band because of the songs, not because of a sort of fashion phase, then it's probably natural they stayed with it and want to know what, you know, in terms of the songs, what happens next, you know, what's the next bit of the story. Cold dawn won't come
She goes back. The saying to myself, you're such a lucky guy to have a girl like her. It's truly a dream come true. Of all the girls in the world, she's in love with you. Oh yeah, but that was just an imagination.
Running away with me.
when you write for what you want to write for. And the thing is, because I'd always written songs, and it, you know, it happened that we'd done them with Deacon Blue, I just really always carried on to try to write songs. But over the last couple of years, especially having done the tour, it started to be a possibility of working together. And songs that I wanted to work on with Lorraine, that, you know, our voices, the suit of our voices, songs that I wanted to work on with Jim, and songs that I thought would be really good for Deacon Blue the tour to do, started to emerge.
Paper boat. for 89. And everything's still sure and free and there to be finished.
I think every time you sleep, believe it or not, when I did that, I think that it's as good a song as I've written. I know that. Mm. I know that Homesick is there. It's a Homesick is the first song that we've had, which we can put in a place in the set like at the end of the show, and we've never had a song that since Dignity. Uh-huh. And that's a kind of good sign because when you've written a song like Dignity, which is a kind of big song, it becomes a kind of another beast in itself. You know, you don't really try and rewrite it. So when something else happens that sounds and the same feel as Dignity, then it comes along naturally, then it's good news.
For me, Homesick kind of is maybe not where we're at right now, but it's a song, you know, in terms of how it sounds and the feel of it, I think that is where the band's at just now, and that kind of longing in the lyric that is, you know, very reminiscent of many Deacon Blue songs. I think that's the one for me.
Yeah, because people can relate to songs on so many levels, and of course, you know, the lyrics about as much about us as much as it is about someone else. It's about our, you know, it's probably the one song that's more about us as a band as it is about a story about someone outside the band. And in a sense, it kind of does sum up totally what's happening for us just now. And it was a real shock to me when we played the Royal Concert Hall 2 years ago. I mean, that was when people ask me, what is your favourite gig? That is my favourite gig I've ever played, because it took me really by surprise just how much us doing a gig in Glasgow meant to folk. And Homesick is about a longing, and a longing just to do this and to do it and enjoy doing it for as long as you can.
That's me. Recognize the face from familiar shoes. Don't walks up on the street. He's a worker for the council. Has been 20 years. And he takes no shit off nobody. And a letter off the gutter. And puts it in the back. And never thinks to mutter. And he packs his lunch in a sunblast bag. The children call him Bowman. He never lets on. And I know cause he once told me. He let me know a secret. About the money in his kitty. He's gonna buy a dinghy. Gonna call her Dignity. I'll see her on the west coast, through the villages and towns. I'll be on my holidays, family doing the rounds. Yeah, ask me how I got it, I'll say.
I said no money.
She isn't she pretty, but she.
I'm going to be Beverly Shea here for a second. You know, in these days, if... Hey, Jim, give us a bit of talk over. Give us a bit of music here. A bit, something sentimental. Something your mother taught you. In these days of hard times in the... That's good, Jim. It's better than I hoped for. You've got to think about the opportunities that lie within the boundaries of the city. And this is a song about one such young man. He feels enclosed. He feels the world is against him. He feels in chains. He has nowhere to go. So taking life in his own hands, he quietly, and no hurting nobody, scrambles over the walls of Barlinnie. Was mental. Just mental. It's
called The Day That Jackie Jumped the Jail.
Jackie jumped the jail with a big explosion just as he got to the motorway. 30,000 fireworks took the piss out of Princess Street Gardens. She went up to the Budgie for a live night. See the smell of cabbages first thing in the morning. In the cream of the barley, there was a frame or two to be had down the Imperial on Mitchell Street. 5 years ago, he buried her memory with a snooker cue in a Daft Green student's head. Still, he remembered everything. Yellow stilettos that squeezed her toes. So you told her the whole story. She took him into the wee pen behind coo curtains. She let him feel her all over for the last time. 10 minutes later, me wagon picked him up.
These are just the same.
I used to hate doing old songs. I used to kind of get, we used to do whole periods, whole tours where we didn't do Dignity, Real Gone Kid. And we used to kind of strop around and be bad and be all artistic and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And it's just rubbish, really, because as soon as I'm kind of stopped tuning, if I do go to a gig, I'm about four songs in and going, come on, do something we know. So I find it very frustrating. And every time I go to a gig, I would have written a better set list than that. So I just think that you've got to entertain people. People have got to stay with you, and they've got to feel that they're getting value for money, and they want to hear these songs.
Stranger to the back, to this world.